Hey everybody, welcome to BODS Mayhem Hour. I'm your host, John the BOD, a.k.a. the BOD Father, and I have an awesome interview set up for you guys this evening. This man needs no introduction, but his name is Doyle, and this is his second time being on BODS Mayhem Hour. Doyle, man, thanks for taking time out to do this interview with me again.
Anytime, John.
You know, I gotta say, I've got the advanced copy of Abominator. This is really heavy. I mean, you guys really knocked this one out of the park.
Yeah, man. We got a whole nother one ready to go. We just got to go home and mix it.
Oh, sweet.
Need two records.
Oh, nice. So, did you guys ever think about doing, like, an EP with this one, and then you know, with the next one, do, like, part two of it or something?
They're both going to have 12 songs on them.
Let's talk about the Abominator CD here, why I got you on here. I know you came out with Gorgeous Frankestein with that CD, but was there anything that was on the Abominator CD that you guys might have left out on the Gorgeous Frankestein CD as far as heaviness, extra songs, whatever?
No, nothing was left off of that. None of that. All the songs that are on this one were just music then, and then I hooked up with Alex Story from Cancer Slug, and I realized I wasn't good at writing vocal melodies and lyrics. You know, really, it's not my forte. I'm a music guy, and I was thinking, who do I know that is a great fucking writer? And so, like, a light bulb, I was like, Alex Story. So I called him up, and ironically, he was walking into a Danzig show in Houston when I called him on the phone, and I said, yo, man, you want to write with me? I got a bunch of, you know, music written. It's all in song form. It's all arranged. It's all programmed. It's all demoed out. It just has nothing on it. I said, yeah, send it all. So I did, and he sent me back. I sent him Mark of the Beast. He sent it back, and it is exactly how it is on the record, and it was just, I was like, that's exactly what the fuck I wanted, man. That's it. It's perfect.
Yeah, if you listen to his music with Cancer Slug, I mean, he's just the same with you on the Doyle Abominator CD.
He is one of the greatest songwriters of our time. He's amazing. He's the best musician I know right there. That guy's, he's out of his mind.
I like his stage presence.
Oh, he's great.
You know, he's always got the crowd, from what I've seen on tour with you guys and YouTube stuff, that he's always got the crowd into it with you all.
Yeah, when he first played with us, you know, it was Gorgeous Frankenstein, but first show he did with us, I used to see him on the computer, and he was playing really small places, and I was like, I don't know, you know, if he's going to be nervous, you know, we're stepping onto a bigger stage, we're playing with Danzig, blah, blah, blah. He got up there, he just owned the stage in a second. It was not even my stage anymore, it was his. I was like, right on, this is the guy.
That is awesome.
Great.
What do you think that Alex brings to the Doyle band? What do you think he brings to it?
He finishes the song. I give him a canvas of music, you know, and he makes it a song. He is the storyteller. That's why his name is Story.
That's awesome. I think he fits this band perfectly. You know, like I said, his stage presence is awesome, and he's just a beast.
He's perfect.
Yeah, and he's just
perfect to be my singer. He's perfect because he's an animal.
Yeah, that's what I was going to say. He is a beast on lyrics.
He's a beast, totally.
That's for sure. I know that this is the advanced copy right now going out of Abominator. Is there another Abominator going to be coming out with extra stuff on it in the near future, possibly?
Yeah. It's going to probably, we're talking about the middle of June, but we got to see when we get home. We're still working on our distributors, see who we're going to go with right now. We're still in that discussion, but when I get home, we're going to get the other ones pressed. They're going to be a digipack, and so it's going to open up like a book. Going to have all the words in a booklet, tons of pictures. It's going to have an extra song on it. It's going to have different artwork on the back, and it's going to have an extra song. It's not going to be on iTunes. You know, it's just going to be on the hard copy, and the extra song is really good, too. It actually came out as one of the best ones.
How's the fans digging the new songs from you guys?
All I hear is good stuff. Everybody likes a different song. Nobody can say what it sounds like. It doesn't sound like anybody. It sounds like, I don't know what it sounds like. Everybody says, what does it sound like? I don't know. Whatever I write, that's what it sounds like.
I love it. I love your guitar breakdowns, as always. You know, since the Misfits days, I mean, you still tear it up as you did before, but I mean, you guys are really kicking ass on this CD, and thanks for bringing it to us.
Oh, yeah, you're welcome. I only got a couple hours a day to work on music. That's why this record's taking so long. I got about 3 or 4 hours a night to work on it, you know, to record it, you know, and if I could stay home all day, I could write one a year easily, maybe two.
I mean, you could get, like, you know, the digital packs. Amazon.com and iTunes and CD Baby, stuff like that. You can get them cheap, honestly. I mean, it's just just a couple of bucks, and that's what I do. I get mine off there all the time, and God, my collection's huge since I've been. I buy all of them like that now, and I haven't bought a hard copy in, wow, it's been a while, because it's just right there.
I'm a hard copy guy, man. I ain't downloading nothing. I want to help the bands. Like, I don't even go buy Glenn's. I mean, I don't even get CDs from Glenn when he makes them. I go buy them.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. All my friends, I buy their records. I don't ask them for them. Even last tour, Tommy's like, hey, you want one of my CDs? I'm like, no, Tommy, I'm going to go buy it.
Yeah, yeah. That's what I actually was going to do with yours, too. I was going to get this one and plus go buy the hard copy.
Yeah.
I like the old vinyls, too. I like those. I think those are still kick-ass.
Oh, we're doing vinyl. It's going to probably be a double vinyl because the songs are, like, an average about 4 minutes, and we want high quality on it, so probably three songs on a side and be a double album, and it'd be 24-bit recording rather than 16, which is a CD.
Now, with Abominator, I have to say my favorite song I've been listening to a lot on here is Love Like Murder. I love that one a lot. That's a really good one.
See, everybody's got a different one.
Yeah, I mean, they're all good, but, you know... But the song that sticks in my head the most is Love Like Murder, and also, too, is Learn to Bleed. That one's on there, too. I'm just amazed with the CD that you guys have put out.
Thank you. Yeah, we worked hard on it, man. We worked real hard. We learned a lot. We bought all the gear. We recorded that ourselves.
Bands now, that's what they're doing. I've seen a lot of them break away.
You have to. That record would have cost us $1 million to make. That's how many hours we put into it.
Jeez, that's insane. How's the tour been so far with you and Glenn Danzig so far? I know you guys are big buddies and stuff still, but how's the tour going on?
It's great. Tonight is the last show we're doing for this little leg, and then we go to Europe in the middle of June. Tonight we're playing the Revolver Golden Gods Awards. We go on at 9:45 West Coast time, right before Metallica we go on, and we're doing two Danzig songs, and then I come out, we do two Misfits songs.
I was actually going to watch it tonight. It's live on Access TV for the first time. And this is what, second? No, it's fifth year, ain't it? Fifth year for this show. And this is the first time it's actually going to be on TV, or Access
TV. It's also on Xbox Live,
yep.
Whatever that is.
Yeah, for all you online gamers, they have that out there, too. You can check it out. That's what they had it on last year, too, which sucked. I wanted to watch it, and I couldn't because I just don't play online games. It's just not my thing. Are you excited to see any bands that are going to be on this bill tonight? Because I know they got Metallica, Five Finger Death Punch. I know Hellstorm's going to be there. A bunch of them.
I'm excited to see Anthrax because they're friends of mine. I haven't seen them in a long time. They got a couple special guests coming up with them. They're going to do something really cool. I guess it's top secret, so I'm not saying that. I want to see Metallica. I want to meet all the guys that, you know, that I admire, you know, and just give them my CD and tell them I want to open for them, you know?
Definitely. I definitely going to buy the hard copy of this, help support out, and do what I can for you, as always. I told you that before when I first interviewed you, so, I mean, anything I can do to put up here for you guys, I'll definitely do it for you, Doyle. I was hoping for that.
Yeah. Hopefully, we get to get on the East Coast leg of the Danzig tour, you know?
Yeah.
He's going to do an East Coast leg, I think, like, either August or September, maybe October. I don't know.
I'll keep my eye open out for it. Now, you said that you guys are coming out with another album this year. Do you know?
Well, maybe not this year because this one hasn't come out yet.
Okay.
I thought we were going to get this one out earlier, but we're going to have the other one done, you know, very soon. I have three songs to record, and they're done. They're all done. I just got to record them. I just don't have the time. And when I get home, I'll do them.
Okay.
And then we'll mix it probably after the European tour. You just got to title it and artwork it up, you know what I mean? We don't know what song we're going to call it, you know, or name or whatever. We have no title for it.
Working on that new CD whenever it does drop, but right now, do you have a favorite song off of it that you really like a lot?
Off the Abominator?
Yeah, off the Abominator and plus the new one that you're working on.
Abominator, I don't even have to say Abominator because it was the last one we wrote. Usually the last song that we write is my favorite because every time he sends them back to me after I send them to him, Alex, I'm just like, I put the headphones on, I listen to it, I read the words, and I just fucking go crazy, you know? Like, this is great!
Yeah.
So, I guess Abominator, which was the last song we did, and we came up with the name of the song before we wrote it, so that was the title for the album, and then I sent him a song, and he just made it Abominator, you know?
Cool. I like the art on the CD, too. Well, the one that's on there right now. I think that's really cool.
Yeah. The front cover, that's a good friend of mine, Michael Arago, took that picture in New York at the Nokia Theater.
Uh-huh. That is awesome.
So, yeah.
with the next leg of the tour coming up, are there any spots that you're excited to play at? Or
You know what? I don't have a computer. I have no idea where we're going.
Okay. How long did it actually take you guys to the Abominator?
It took us about a year and a half because we started and we did about 5 songs and it wasn't right. We needed some more equipment, you know what I mean? We needed to get and learn Pro Tools. You know, Dr. Chud did that. I didn't learn it. I'm not a computer guy, so he got it all down and it took a while. You know, we got to go have regular jobs. So if we didn't have regular jobs, we could do it in about, 2 or 3 months.
Mm-hmm. I do this for fun. You know, this is my hobby. I like doing this. And I have a regular day job. So it's tough. I know what you're saying. It's tough to balance stuff and plus have an everyday life with everything. So it's...
Well, yeah, it's the people that steal the music that makes us have a job. Because if they didn't steal it and we got paid for every record we did and every song, we would get to stay home and make more.
Yeah.
They don't get it.
Yeah. Like I said, this CD is awesome. Like I said, anything that I can do for you guys to help promote it, I'll do whatever I can. And don't hesitate to ask us.
Okay. Sounds good, man.
Doyle, I want to thank you for being on the show this evening. I really appreciate your time, and I know tonight you're doing the Revolver Golden Gods Awards. Man, rock out like you always do on that axe that you play with, because I know you play like a beast, just like Alex does and Dr. Chud. So, one last question for you. We've talked about everybody else in the band. I know you got Chud and Alex and you. What about the bass player? Let's talk about him a little bit.
Left-hand Graham. He used to be in Graves' band. We had another bass player, and... he was the singer, and then when I said Alex is going to be the singer, he was not into it, so we were like, all right, man, that's cool. And Chuck says, how about Graham? I said, bring him down. I said, give him a CD, give him the demo. He gave him the demo, and then a week later, he learned 11 of those songs and came down and played them right on. And I was like, holy shit. It was like we played together forever. We did 11 songs, and they all sounded perfect. And I was like, wow. He asked me one note. He goes, what's this note? I'm like, that note is crazy because it's the same friggin' note as the note before, but it doesn't sound like it, you know. And he just figured him out.
Yeah,
you know, came down. He's spot on, man. He's a good kid and good. Well, everybody in our band is nice and gets along great, man. It's really good.
How is it with Dr. Chud, dude? I know I asked you that before. I know I've heard some stories.
He's out of his mind. He's crazy. He's I call him the ultimate professional. You know, he's just so into being a drummer and a musician, and then he's got his wild side, and he's funny, and he's out of his mind.
I bought the CD of him actually last year of Dr. Chud's X-Ward, and really liked it, man. Really good CD he put out.
Yeah, he does a good job, man.
I didn't know he actually sung. I was like, wow, it's Dr. Chud. The man of many things, as I call him.
Yes, absolutely.
So how can fans reach out to you guys and say we still love your music and want to support you, and how can they do that, Doyle?
Just go on the official Doyle.com website.
And they can pick up the advanced copy of Abominator. How can they do that?
You know what? I don't know if they can do that. We're selling them at the shows. I don't know what we're doing with that right now. We started the website right before I left. I haven't even seen it. I don't know what's going on.
Okay.
I'm doing this right now. This is like a great promotional tour for us to tell everybody that Doyle's the name of the band now, because we're selling the CDs at the show here.
Yeah, I know we were talking about that last time. It was Gorgeous Frankestein, but you said you wanted to, you know, focus on just your stuff, just you.
Well, the thing is, nobody recognized me being Gorgeous Frankestein. They seen that name and they don't know it's me. I don't have enough money to promote that is me. And when we opened for Danzig, I'd have, 15, 20 people a night after show. I didn't know your band was playing. I didn't know you had a band. Or when we did our own tour, there'd be 50 people there because they didn't know. And they'd be like, oh, wow, we didn't even know you had a band. It just happened to come out tonight, you know? So
that's
better, because now I got Alex working with me and the stuff's way better and we just switched gears. It was actually Alex's idea to change the name of the band.
They know it as Doyle, you know?
A no-brainer.
Oh, yeah. Exactly. If you've been in the music world, you know, like punk, horror, stuff like that, you know who Doyle is.
Well, here's the thing. Keep it simple. Don't let anybody think. They can't. You can't make people think, because then they don't think. If it says Doyle, then they know exactly what it is.
Yep. Thank you for being on the show, man. I really appreciate it. And go rock out tonight at the Revolver Golden Gods Awards. Keep doing what you guys are doing. And, I mean, like I said, anything Uber City Radio and my show can do for you, please, man, don't hesitate to ask, because we'll do it for you.
Thanks, John.
Hey, brother, that's not a problem.
Okay, man.
I appreciate it, Doyle.
All right, take care.
You too, buddy. Bye.